So the National Association of Realtors just released a brand new housing report, which I think shows us exactly what we're going to see before we see a housing market crash, before we see an end to this crazy real estate market that we find ourselves in right now. So the report that we're going to be taking a look at today is titled Buyer Competition Intensifies, 4 offers for every home sold in February 2021. But real quick, my name is Malcolm Lawson. I'm a full-time real estate agent and I put out market update videos just like this one on a regular basis. So if you want to stay up to date on the real estate market trends and the value of your home, you should really consider subscribing. So let's jump right into this report. The opening paragraph reads, "With demand for homes outpacing new listings, buyer competition continues to intensify. On average, there were 4 offers per every home sold in February." So that is the national average. And I can tell you anecdotally, that is what we're seeing in our market as well here in Maryland. The most that I've seen is 11 offers on a property within just a few days. But it's most homes are getting 3 to 4 offers within the first week. Now, this is kind of regionally specific, right? If you're in a more rural area, you may not be as competitive. I have a friend who's a real estate agent in Northern Virginia. She tells me that most homes in Northern Virginia are getting 20 to 30 offers within the very first week of being on the market. So if you're a buyer in a much more dense area like Northern Virginia, you have a lot of competition and you have to kind of set your expectations accordingly. I tell a lot of my buyers now, like, hey, we may need to submit 3 to 4 offers before you finally get one accepted. And even though the last time you bought a home, it may only have taken you a few weeks or maybe a month of house hunting submitting offers, now it may take you 3 to 6 months before you finally find a house that you love and get an offer accepted. And so that's what I'm seeing here in Maryland, but this is a national trend. We are seeing that exact situation all across the country. And we take a look at this chart here, it shows us on average how many offers homes are getting going all the way back to 2015. And we see that in 2015, on average, homes are getting about 2 offers. And that number fluctuated between 2 and 2.5 for the last handful of years until April 2020, when we see that number dramatically increase. And according to this chart, we're really not seeing a slowing in the number of offers that homes are getting. And the report goes on to say that properties typically sold in 20 days, a record low since the housing market recovery in 2012. And 74% of existing homes sold in February 2021 were on the market for less than 30 days. And once again, we can see that in this chart. Going all the way back to 2011, homes were on the market for an average of about 100 days. And that number has just been decreasing for the last 10 years. And another interesting thing that we can take from this chart is that the real estate market typically is cyclical, right? It sees a big boom in the spring and the summertime, and then it slows way down in the fall and wintertime. And we can actually see that in this chart showing how long homes are taking to sell. But if you look at the last cycle, it's flat. We don't see a large spike in the wintertime like we have over the last 10 years. Instead, that average of 20 days on market has remained consistent for the past 12 months. And that's a little concerning. That's actually a pretty major red flag that we're not seeing this typical yearly slowdown that we often see in the wintertime. According to this data, the demand for real estate is so high right now that that buying pressure still continued in the winter months, which is not what we typically see. Typically, the real estate market grinds to a halt during the winter months because most people, if they have the choice, they're going to move in the spring and the summertime when there's nicer weather, not when it's freezing cold and snow outside. So for me, I find that really interesting that we've broken that yearly trend in that yearly cycle according to this data. And I'm really interested to see what happens in the spring and summertime if the days on markets actually decrease even further. So the report goes on to break down these average days on market by specific states as well. And according to this report, in Idaho and South Dakota, properties sold even faster with a median at 15 days on market. And as you can see from this map, most states, the average days on market was between 16 and 30. A very few states, the average days on market was 61 to 90. In 2 states, the average days on market was less than 15 days, that's South Dakota and Idaho. In only 2 states, the average days on market was 31 to 45. And in only 2 states, the average days on market was 61 to 90 days. And that's the interesting thing about the real estate market is you do have these larger macro trends that you see across the nation, but a lot of this is very hyper local and hyper specific. You know, I pointed out earlier that in Northern Virginia, they're getting 20 to 30 offers per property. But I'm willing to bet in Southern Virginia or in a more rural part of Virginia, that number is far, far lower. So you have a lot of these big macro trends, but you also have a lot of much smaller micro trends that are going to influence what your local real estate market is experiencing. And this report goes on to break down some of these numbers by specific regions in the US, and they've broken the US into four distinct regions. So according to this report, in the Western region, homes priced 250 to 750 were typically under contract in 8 days. In the South, properties in the $250,000 to $750,000 price range were typically under contract in about 2 weeks. And price range does play a big factor in all of this as well. If you're selling a home for $100,000 or $1 million, your days on market is going to be a lot longer. You're not going to get as many offers as if you'd sell closer to the medium home price between $300,000 and $400,000. At least that's what the average home price is here in Maryland. So the next section of the report is where I find it gets really interesting and kind of hints at what has to happen before we see a housing market crash or a correction in this wild market. And according to this report, 2.7 million more homes for sale is needed to be on the market. As of January, the combined inventory of existing homes and new homes for sale was just at 1.7 months. As this chart below shows, a balanced housing market is one that requires the inventory of homes for sale to be equivalent to about 6 months of the monthly pace of demand. So what they're saying here is that we are in a very unbalanced real estate market right now. We have a huge, huge demand for real estate and very, very low inventory. And over the last 12 months, that demand has just consistently increased and that inventory has consistently decreased. So we are absolutely in a seller's market. As of right now, if no other homes were put on the market, we would buy all of the homes in the market in 1.7 months. Now, we use this months of inventory as a metric to determine if we're in a buyer's market or a seller's market. And 6 months is generally considered a balanced market. That's really the mark that we wanna see on a large macro trend is 6 months of inventory. If we have more than 6 months of inventory, that means we have a lot more inventory than we do buyers, and we're in a buyer's market. And oftentimes we see home prices declining when we're in a buyer's market. Right now we're in an extreme seller's market, and they're saying we need 2.7 million homes for sale in order for us to get into a balanced market, which is what we really want to be at with 6 months of inventory. The report goes on to say, to meet 6 months of this monthly pace of demand, 3.79 million homes need to be on the market as of 2021. But the actual level of inventory of new and existing homes for sale was only at 1.07 million, yielding a shortage of 2.72 million homes on the market in January 2021. So the next chart I'm going to show you is the one that I find the most interesting and I think shows us exactly what we're going to see before we see a real estate market crash or an end to this crazy market that we're in right now. So the blue line on this chart shows us what the actual inventory in the market is that we have. The yellow line shows us what the inventory needs to be for us to have a balanced market of 6 months of inventory. And as you can see, right before the last real estate market crash in 2006, these two lines crossed. And we saw that the actual number of inventory skyrocketed, where the number of inventory needed to reach 6 months of inventory plummeted. And that crossing of those two lines indicated that we had far more sellers in the market and inventory than we did buyers, and we are entering into a buyer's market and a real estate market crash. And you can see that in 2011, these two lines crossed again, and for a very brief moment, we were in a balanced market. We had about 6 months of inventory, but we then entered into a seller's market, and that gap between these two lines has just been growing consistently for the past 10 years or so. And right now, the gap between these two lines of where we should be and where we're at with inventory is the largest it has ever been in the last 20 years. So we are nowhere near a balanced market, and we're not just in a seller's market, we're in an extreme seller's market right now. So these two charts are definitely something you wanna watch closely to indicate when we're gonna see a market crash. And if you go back to 2006, you can see that these two lines changed directions fairly quickly. Over just a few months, we went from a seller's market into a buyer's market. So it is totally possible that something like that could happen again. And when it does, it's most likely going to happen very quickly. So the report then goes on to talk about what we need to do to get back into a balanced market of about 6 months of inventory and out of this extreme seller's market that we're in right now. The report says that addressing this backlog requires a combination of policies such as upzoning and increasing construction labor. But these policies won't meet the backlog of housing shortages quickly. Buyers should expect continued strong market competition, a fast-turning market, and continued home price appreciation of about 7% in 2021. So according to the National Association of Realtors, in order to get back into a more balanced market, we need some policies implemented on a national level as well as on local level. A lot of states need to change their zoning policies and incentivize builders to put out more inventory in the market. You know, I made a video a while back breaking down Joe Biden's housing policies, and one of the policies that he's implementing is going to be a credit for first-time home buyers. But my concern is that all that is going to do is just increase the number of buyers in the market even higher. That's just going to add more fuel to this fire of a seller's market that we're in. What I'd rather see him do that's going to help out first-time home buyers as well as everybody else is take steps to increase the inventory in the market. That is what we need, and that is going to help out everybody in the real estate market. So according to this report, the National Association of Realtors predicts that we're going to continue seeing the trends that we're seeing right now for the rest of 2021, and they're predicting that home prices are going to continue to increase by at least 7% going over the rest of this year. Hey, if you want to see Harvard University's prediction of what the housing market is going to do in 2021, you can check that out right here. And don't forget to subscribe for more real estate market update videos just like this one. Hit that little bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you over in the next video.